This Sunday at Faith North, we're going to be looking at John chapter 2, verses 13 to 25. During the Passover, Jesus and his disciples went to Jerusalem to celebrate and visit the temple. Jesus saw shame and he was very disappointed in what he saw in the temple as merchants were actually inside the temple area selling items. Now, this made it very difficult for more people to be in that space of worship. This was a disgrace, and so Jesus got mad, and justly so. He fashioned a whip out of some rope and chased the deceptive merchants and their animals right out of the temple area. He overturned the tables, and he proclaimed this, "Get these out of here. Stop turning my Father's house into a market." Well, this Sunday at Faith North, we're going to be talking about purity of worship. Enjoying life in His name comes through pure worship, and we will discover three ways to cultivate genuine or pure worship. It is important, though, that we understand that worshiping God requires purity. What if we began to teach our kids that maybe on a Saturday night, we shouldn't stay out that late before church and start to prepare for Sunday worship on Saturday night? Get some good sleep so that you are well prepared for worshiping God on Sundays. You know, what if we decided to pray before we got out of the car to prepare our hearts for worship? You know, I often pray that God would allow the distractions of life to be put on pause while we worship together in church. Now, if we can put the stress from work, the family arguments, the worry about finances aside, so that we can concentrate on what God would have for us in worshiping Him, you know, this shouldn't only be done on Sundays before church, but any time that we open God's Word, we pray, or we have Bible study together, because when we gather to worship, we want to have the most pure form of worship that we can. You see, God deserves this from us, and I hope that we can embrace Jesus as the true temple for pure worship. Hope to see you this Sunday. God bless.